Hello and welcome to another traditional Tinkerer's Cube Draft. Let's see what kind of a concoction I'm gonna get this time. Yeah, I don't really know what is the best approach in here. I mean, I could take like the spell god to weird. There is a blue-red spells archetype, also the Saheeli woodwork for that thing, Ranger of Eos for an aggressive white deck, maybe white red could be one. Yeah, I mean, I don't think there's any particularly extremely strong option here. I guess the Ranger of Eos is pretty nice if you get to pick one of those very nice one drops, but I think this weird is pretty safe because, I mean, once you get one counter on it, it's a 3-mana 3-3 already, and then it might be very easy to get the spell-focused deck and then grow this even more. There's also the Siren Storm Tamer if I want that blue-white skies archetype to happen at some point, which is interesting enough that I want to sometimes draft that, but I don't think this is the kind of payoff for that. So I'm going to take the spell Gotcha Weird and see if I can get some non-creature spell focused deck here, and there's actually a very nice continuation for that pick in the Goblin Wizardry. Now there is of course like the Archon of Redemption here, very nice for those life gain stuff, and then there's Angel of Vitality and this, so the life gain deck is actually very supported in this cube. Even this thing has lifelink, although it's not exactly for the life gain deck, but if my first pick is a spell god to weird, I'm gonna take a Goblin Wizard as my second pick. They work so nicely in the same kind of a deck. Ox of Agonas. How about that? There is also a Lullmage's Domination. I mean, I don't think the other cards in this pack are that amazing to continue this kind of plan. So I think the pick is between the Ox and the Lullmage's Domination. I'm not sure if the Ox of Agonas is that great if I'm gonna have a large focus on spells. But then again, this is gonna be pretty tough. There is a, you know, this kind of a slight mill theme in this cube, but blue-red won't have that kind of stuff, so this is gonna be a very expensive steel spell, but I mean, it still might be what I want here instead of the Ox. If I have a lot of spells, reactive spells, it might be a little bit tougher to try to empty your hand, and you don't want to really play this if you have good spells in your hand still, so I'll take the Lullmage's Domination for now, and we'll see where it goes from there. Okay, so now there are nice options. First, this is a very good card. But then again, I have those red spells and I do kind of want to focus with the plan I'm here doing. And I might just take the double vision because of that. There's also the Rogrin Triome. I mean, I don't necessarily have to be blue-red, but I most likely probably have will be if this deck comes together, but and this would be a nice mana fixer for that deck. Allows me for some white options too, but I think the double vision might be here. I have only one instant for now, but I'll get to pick more of them. Okay, Thassa's Intervention is pretty nice here, and well, yet another Triome that actually produces both these colors. And now that I pick these, I'm going to want to play blue. But I'm going to take the Intervention here. And hopefully one of these Triomes comes back. It's possible, I think. And here, okay, we have decent options here. I mean, I could even take the Midnight Clock here. I could take the Goblin Rally. I could take the Dark Dweller, just a, you know, some kind of 2-drop. But I don't think that's the pick. Even the Iroas's Blessing might be a fine, you know, removal spell, but I think I'm gonna want to focus on instants and sorceries thanks to the double vision. Both of these, of course, trigger also from other non-creature spells than instants and sorceries, but yeah, the Illumination isn't bad either, but I guess I'm gonna take the Goblin Rally some board presence here, and well, there's some token synergies now. I mean, not synergies, but token creation here now, which may make it possible that I might pick some go white cards. Who knows? Like venerated Loxodon wouldn't even be that bad. But is it just going to be like the an action here? It's going to be like a 2-3 most of the time. I won't be having that many red permanents here. But I mean, I guess I could take the counter spell, but I don't think I want these reactive spells. They don't work so well with this prowess, and the especially double vision is pretty useless with this thing. Do I want to try some white here? Yeah, I guess I'll take the Anax here. Well, red is certainly open here. Okay, there is Honored Crop Captain 2, which is kinda good. So if I had taken a white card in there, it would have been nice continuation, and I could just consider forgetting the blue. Blue doesn't seem to be open at all. But maybe I'll just take the Gutter Snipe here. Yeah. Okay, I'd get this Sahili here. I think I'm gonna take it. It's gonna make me quite a few server tokens, I think, and I hope. I'm gonna take it here. I could take the Eleonora here, but I mean, I have some expensive stuff here already, so it's not that exciting necessarily. Today I craft my victory. Well, the Cartouche of Knowledge might just be the more interesting one than the 2-drop. Yeah, this has to attack, so it's not really very defensive. I guess I'll take the Cartouche. Not a great choice here, but fine pick, given the other options. I mean, not a great card for this deck necessarily, but from those options it was a good choice to pick. Okay, I'll take the Axe of Agonas now. I mean, there is the Rootbound Crack, maybe making it possible to still play green, but I guess I don't have that many blues, but yeah, let's take the Axe now. Phoenix of Ash. Grim Initiate. I suppose the Phoenix might be better. I mean, this is not even that great blocker. It has only one power, so I'll take the Phoenix here. It seems red is super open, and most other colors not so much. Okay, Act of Treason is not an effect I'm going to be that interested in, although with double vision it could be interesting, but I don't know. Let's take the 2-drop here. Okay, yeah, red is open. Don't have that many instant and sorceries, but I suppose I will have. Well, I mean, this is a 2-mana 2-2. It's actually more reliable early game blocker, so I like this more now that you think. I mean, yeah, it got auto-picked, but I would have chosen this anyway. So there is a Bubble Snare, which is at least a defensive card, and there's not much else for my colors. I don't want to really consider any other colors here. And Bubbles there will trigger Sahili, Spellcoacher, Weird, and Goblin Wizardry. It doesn't trigger a Double Vision or a Gutter Snipe, but I'll take the defensive card here. Ral, Quench, Charter Course, Murmuring Mystic. Well, this is gonna be good, but again, I don't have that many instant and sorceries. I hope I can pick them up, but I mean, this one isn't that great either. If I don't have a bunch of instant and sorceries, I think I take the 1/5 blocker rather than Rull here. Feria Vandal, Cutthroat, Spectral Sailor, Ominous Seas. I mean, I don't have that many instant speed stuff here. I have actually quite a few of them only, like 2 currently. So this Cutthroat won't be that great, but I don't have card draw either that much. There's the Cartouche, which I might not even play in here. And these are not even card draw spells. Thassa's Intervention and Dark Dweller don't draw cards. They give card advantage in other ways. I mean, I could just take the Spectral Sailor in here to maybe try to draw some cards. Okay, I think that might be my pick here. Thassa. Fire Prophecy though. And Opt and Colossus Dismissal. I actually... Yeah, I could take a bunch of cards in here, but I think the pick here now has to be the Fire Prophecy to have some defensive plays available. I hope that one of these will come back to me. Okay, Dracuseth, not for this deck. Weight of Memory. Maybe I'll just take the Electric Dominance in here. It could be okay here. Yeah, let's take it. It's expensive, but can work. Wow, this pack. Definitely this blue-red is open in this direction. Oh boy. I mean, the barrel is pretty nice. Instant and Sorceries. Currently, I am at 6 of them. And all of them have generic mana in their mana cost, so they will be getting cheaper. But there is also a Soul Scar Mage. There is like a Flame Spill. But I think the barrel is just a better option here now. I don't have any counter spells, but the first ability is the more important one. Alright. Oh man, this is pretty wild here. Yeah, I mean, there are so many good cards for this deck. 6 of them, Ogre of Bolas, I don't know. I mean, I kind of want to just take the Sorcery in here. Quasi duplicate isn't... let's take the Precision Bolt. It's like the worst burn spell available, but it's still an interaction and works nicely with my triggered abilities. Okay, yeah. I'd like to have the Terraminder. Well, why not even this thing and why not this land? But yeah, Experimental Overload. Instant and Sorcery cards in your graveyard. Well, I hope they're gonna be a bunch of them. So let's pick the Experimental Overload in here. Well, this is now not anything interesting. I'll take the Claim the Firstborn. Yeah, Ral came back, but so did these two. I mean, I might just want to have something defensive on the early game. Or I could just take the Charter Course, of course. How much early drops I have? I don't have that many. I think I need the 2-drop creature here just to have some, you know, place for early turns. And here, I mean, I didn't pick that many instants, but there are like a few. I still might take the Cutthroat. There's also one Flash guy rather than these things. Okay. Departed Deckhand. I'm not gonna play it, but I'm gonna pick it. I don't think I'm gonna splash any white here. I haven't seen any lands for these colors, which is sad. Someone has picked the blue-red lands, or they simply haven't been opened. Milling is irrelevant here, so let's take this, although I'm not gonna play it either. I'm gonna cut the unplayables when I'm in the deck building mode then. Well, milling might be relevant for the Lull Mage's domination, but I don't think it's enough. I got even the Burning Prophet. That I think I'm going to play. It says like non-creature, yeah. Alright, Werric's Patient Rebuilding Wizard's Lightning. That is a good one. But I really kind of want to consider the Wizard's Lightning. I have here some expensive stuff here already. I'm gonna take the Wizard's Lightning now. Do I have Wizards in here? Like, heck. Okay, 4. Don't know how many of them I'm gonna cut, but we will see. Wantress Gargoyle. Well, I mean, there is a Sprite Dragon in here. I'm gonna pick that. Oh, there is an Evolving Wilds here. That hurts to pass it, but I mean, the Sprite Dragon is just exactly the kind of 2-drop this deck wants to have, so I'm going to take it and be sad about passing the one mana fixer I could have had in this deck. I might even not play the Lull Mage's Domination because the triple blue may be problematic if I don't have any fixing available. Yeah, but yeah, the Sprite Dragon is just too good in here to ignore. I don't have any artifacts for this thing. Well, I do have targets for the Dowser. There is also Dance with Devils and Shivan Fire. So good options, a lot of good options. I will have a ton of cards to make though. I have no idea about my final build right now. There's like already 6 cards I'm gonna be cutting. Yeah, there are a few obvious cuts, but I don't think there are 6 obvious cuts. Mana Curve says that 4 and 5 slots are... I mean, I guess I'll take the Dowser. It's just so much value. Yeah, I'm gonna take it. Runaway Steam King. Neutralize. Silent Departure. Well, with the amount of 3 mana... with the amount of red spells I have, I think the Steam King is gonna be pretty nice here. Still no blue-red lands. Someone else is picking those. Alright then. Angrath? It's not the worst, actually. But I don't know if the menace is something I care about too much. I could just take the Supreme Will too. But yeah, it's gonna make a guy anyway and then maybe makes another guy if I'm lucky. And I don't have that many 4 drops. Fine, let's take Angrath. It will still trigger all my non-creature triggers. Upgrade. There's a Kasmina too, but I'm gonna take Upgrade here. Yeah, I'm pretty sad I didn't get any of the... didn't get any of the lands here. But I mean, someone just picked the blue-red lands there for one reason or another. Strategic planning. Vyasino. I think I have enough of those 2 drops here. I might take this, but I might even not have a room for this. We will see. Okay, the Pyromancer is... I don't have that many card draw. This is not a card draw effect. I have actually very few card draw effects, so I'm not gonna take it. I could take the Forbidden Friendship, but I think the Mind Stone is what I might want. Although this is a sorcery, it triggers more of my stuff. I'll still take the Mind Stone. It's such a nice one. Okay, I'm gonna take the Werix now. That's just a random 4/4 flyer. And well, I mean, if I have 7 mana, it's gonna bring a friend. Okay, so many cuts to make. And I got even the Skewer the Critics in here. Which I might take over the Dragon Fodder. Yeah, I have 2 drops here. I'll take the Skewer, but I think I'm gonna cut quite a few cards here, so I don't know what's gonna end up being their final deck in here. So many cuts. This is like 15 cuts. Seriously? Well, neutralize definitely, and this is a best of 3 event, so I wanna have potentially more counter spells, but I think I can safely put that to sideboard right away. They just don't do anything. Okay, so if you are watching my content or want to keep watching, I will upload daily draft videos, and for example, Kaldheim set reviews are coming, or I might have published one of them already by the time this video publishes. So if you are interested in my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Alright, none of those are... Yeah, pretty sad that I didn't get any of the lands. I mean, the Triomes in Pack 2, there were 2 Triomes that tapped for blue and red. And then there was the Evolving Wilds I saw, I picked a card over it. And then none of the blue-red duels came to me, and red was so open that it's kind of hard to imagine that someone would be playing blue red, but I suppose someone found a field of the dead and just picked every land they saw, no matter what they are. Okay, let's cut cards. I think the Ox of Agonas goes. I think the Angrath goes in the end. Some of these burn spells. I think Precision Bolt goes. The Skewer is strictly better, and so is the Wizard's Lightning and stuff like that. Phoenix of Ash, not necessarily working. I don't like the triple cost here. I will sideboard this in if opponent has like a cheap creatures, but the mana cost is too tough. tough. I'm having mostly red cards anyway, so I would have to play like 10 islands maybe for this card, so I don't want to do that. And then I can cut at least the departed deckhand, and I guess the Burning Fist Minotaur isn't that great now. Steamkin is gonna be good. I mean, you have so many cuts to make. Well, strategic planning and the cartus, not that great. Cutthroat, how many instants? I think I did pick up some more instants in the end, so it can be okay. Bubble Snare, maybe it's gonna be a sideboard card. Rigging Runner and the Goblin Banner at the sideboard cards. Okay, now it seems better, but still a ton of cards to make. Anax, well, it's gonna be maybe with all these permanent spells, it might have some decent power after all, but I don't care about the satire tokens that cannot block. So I guess I'm gonna cut the Anax too. That's a lot of 4-drops, but all of them are so nice. Well, these are not, this could be like, who cares? For example here, that's 5 4-drops. I kind of want to play them all. But there are 2 cards I need to make. Maybe the Dark Dweller Oracle just is the least useful one. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. That's still 4. That's 5 2-drop creatures. There's Mindstone. I guess I'll cut the Spectral Sailor. I don't think I have that much opportunities to use 4 mana on this thing. So this would be the deck. I definitely play the Mindstone as my 18th mana source. And how many things I have for the double vision here? Instants and sorceries. 10 total. That's gonna be enough. I mean, when you copy one spell, that's kind of, the card pays for itself right away. And when you get to copy another spell, the value is just great. How many non-creatures? 13 non-creatures. So there are gonna be a decent amount of triggers for these things. So this says, target artifact you control. Well, I suppose, yeah, it can target, of course, the servo tokens it creates. And I have the Mind Stone here. Okay, this is the deck. And as you can see, there are very few blue cards in here, but I have double caster, 2-drop, 2-drop, 2-drop. So I need to basically play 8 islands and 9 mountains anyway, to make sure I have the blue for these 2-drops and these double casters most often available. Yeah, man, I really wanted to have the lands here, some kind of lands. Maybe I should have picked the Evolving Wilds. I don't remember actually what I picked over it, but I think I picked something very good over the Evolving Wilds. Okay. Blue-red spells it is. One lander, and this hand doesn't have red. Opponent did mulligan, but I mean red blue sources, and it has 2 blue cards, but I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna lose the mountain here. I hope I would draw one of my 8 islands very soon. Opponent did mulligan to 5, so that makes things a lot easier. Yeah, this mystic can really be a very strong one too. So, yep, I do need just an island and then I will be in a good shape. Opponent at least had a good 2-drop. I'm gonna just kill that, of course. I have some wizards. This good spectacle, but if the fact that's an instant, I'm gonna make it just happen like this. And then I'm gonna probably use the Mind Stone to draw a card next turn if I don't draw a... well, I need an island here and or something I can cast. I mean, I have a lot of red spells in the deck, so Well, still got one of the blue ones. Sweet. My opponent has three colors here. Okay, I guess I'm gonna kill the flyer. I just need to buy some time. Okay, that I don't care about. So this thing will... So I should read it before I... Well, I can play this. So first I create a token, and then I return a card. So one of these burn spells. There it is. Finally. Because I will now start making those 1/1 flyers. Although the opponent does have a thing that can get rid of... Oh, come on. That is so unfair. Oh boy. Well, this is a wizard at least, so the wizard's lightning is gonna be cheap here. But this is not good. Not good at all. I don't think there's any reason to keep the land in my hand. At least I don't remember anything that could matter for that. So, the opponent knows about my wizard lighting. They can make a triple block in here. But they're gonna start generating some stupid counters very soon, so... Yeah, the healer is just gonna be very tough to beat here. Talking about cards that are tough to beat. I mean, do I have to kill something here? I guess I'm just gonna kill them and... I mean, how many cards in the graveyard? Is the Arachne really... No, they're gonna gain so much life here. There's no way I can beat this passive ability of this card. They give lifelink. Oh yeah, you know what? There's no way I'm beating that card. They have already two lifelinkers in there. Yeah, the erasing will be impossible and... all that. Don't want to play the cartoons because the opponent has that spider. Yeah, this is just so nasty. Okay, do I want to have minis for my guys or something? Counter spell. Nah. I think I just have to hope they don't draw the Heliod. Or I get a better start where I can actually, you know, play more spells early in the game. This is... well, this is suboptimal, but I'm gonna go for it. I have the potential of Werix here, and I'm on the play here, of course. And then if I get to double vision and start generating some advantage with these cards, it can be pretty nice. And that's a nice card to draw here. If I can just get an island here, it would be nice. Okay, that's doing nothing now, but can be problematic if they can deploy further cards in there. I mean, they basically, if they have like a couple of tokens here, let's see. If they play just one creature, it's not a big deal at all. And two damage and a two mana spell, but sadly... I'm just gonna play the Werix, but I will offer the trade, of course. If they take the trade, I'm happy. Then the Song of Fulbida doing nothing. So that will have all the... Vigilance, Trample, Indestructible. So basically the attack they make is free. I guess if they have something to kill the Werix, then they have. Okay, they had no play to make there. Interesting. Well, let's try attacking first. Then I'll play the Mystic. Okay, so the Angel of Vitalities. They chose to raise here. Okay, so the Electric Dominance doesn't do anything quite yet, but I can play the Double Vision and then I can go for Double Dominance. They will have this, sadly, these Life Linkers in there. That's going to be problematic, but do I want to steal the... I mean, they're gonna gain 4 in there. Well, I'm gonna actually just trade the Cutthroat away, I think. The Cutthroat is hardly doing anything here. I could also use the Electric Dominance just to deal 3 to one of these guys, but that's... I would get a 1-1 flyer and this would get a counter. But I think I'm gonna just take the Double Vision in here. Except that they're gonna be going to 12. No, they're actually gonna go to... If you would gain life. Okay, I think these are gonna be... It's gonna be in one batch, so that means that they're only gonna get like 5 life. They will gain 4 life in here, and I assume they're gonna go to 13 life here now. No, they actually, it did affect both of these life links separately. Well, good to learn that. Alright, so well, that was kinda good. I mean, I get to play the Experimental Overload, returning the Electric Dominance here. Well, I'm gonna go for it. I mean, if they block with that thing. But they can actually make a... Alright, well, that's actually bad. I guess I'm gonna offer the trade and they're gonna try to make a counter in there. And but if they don't, then I still am fine with that. But yeah, this absolutely was the necessary thing to do here. So I'm still gonna have to kill this if I don't want to lose my verdict. So let's see. I'm gonna have play this as x equals 4. This is gonna get copied. So let's kill this thing. Yep. And then I'm gonna copy it and kill the Trostani here as well. And then when the copy resolves, I can... No, I don't wanna cast anything right now. I'm gonna this. X will be 0, so there's no point casting that thing. I'm gonna decline this. But here then... Oh, but this won't actually do anything. I don't have anything in here. Even if I choose to cast the Experimental Overload, it will actually be resolving and this Electric Dominance will still be in the stack, so I have to decline here actually. It wouldn't have returned it. Okay, so they will have the Ozolith doing its thing, but let's see. I hope I draw the... I mean, I have 8 islands in the deck, so it's surprisingly tough to get a blue mana sources here now. Yeah, that's exactly what I don't want to see here, but I mean, at least I'm gonna... Suppose I'm gonna get 2 1-1s here. Okay. So I'm gonna play this thing. I get the Electric Dominance back here. So first, take the token, and then I'm gonna decline this, so I get the 1-1 from this one too, and then I'm gonna return the Electric Dominance to my hand. And that's gonna be a lot of X damage because it's gonna get doubled, and I'm currently at 7, so I have 10 damage from the Electric Dominance coming up with combination. with the double vision. So Huatli will gain life. He doesn't gain that much life. Can make a token. Can kill my guys, which is irrelevant. So because the Verix Blade Bling is the card that is gonna hit them for 4. Yeah, and then I'm gonna. And I have now these flyers and all. They didn't even attack with the lifelinker. Finally, I got that thing. Okay. I suppose it's gonna be x equals 5 then. Alright, so, I mean, they have the. Rostani discard, and that's also a reason not to play the Lull Mage's Domination. But do I need like a more removal precision bolt? What's their color? So okay, it's mostly green white, and then they're splashing for some red spells. Okay. Do I need some of this stuff? Is there something bad in my main deck? I don't think there's that bad. Burning Prophet might be maybe a bit unexciting actually. I want to have the Guthersnipe for additional damage output. I want to have all these instants and sorceries. I guess the Burning Prophet is a card I don't need, and I can consider some better option like maybe a Phoenix of Ash after all. Cartouche. Neutralize. Well, I mean, the double blue seems to be a problem, but it shouldn't really be with 8 islands, no. And I can always cycle it. Strategic planning. The rest will be going into my graveyard. How many... Is there anything else that cares about the spells in my graveyard other than the experimental overload? I guess the shipwreck dowser cares about that too. I could just play the strategic planning here. Or the flyer or the precision bolt. But they do have the chain web arachnid, so maybe the flyer isn't. Flyer isn't the greatest here. Okay, yeah, let's play the strategic planning. Well, I got my colors and I have a reasonable mana curve. Turn 3. Murmuring Mystic, and then I can start to do stuff with the Spell Gorge weird. Well, does that change anything? They have all the colors, this will make any of those colors. I guess that might just change things. I'd rather kill this than something else. And I might even actually... Don't know though, I want to go there. What I have, yeah, with the Mind Stone I have enough mana sources, so let's lose one of those. And the weird is gonna get a counter from the Mind Stone, so I'm definitely... Oh, that's annoying, I hope I get my Aberrate so that I will at least have the option to get rid of it. Another card that makes racing harder. But yeah, I can play the Mind Stone, and then this will be a 3-3. Maybe I get to connect with it, and this could be a 1 mana spell. Well, they do have 4 mana available, so they can have something big in here. Well, they did not. I could just play this Guthersnipe, but no, I'm gonna play the mana source for this turn. Okay, so they are posing for priority because they have this ability available in there, so I'm not that worried about anything instant speed. Yeah, I could have burned their face there and made this even bigger, but didn't seem like the kind of play I want to be making here. Alright. Well, I guess I don't need my Mystic now. Then I start making some flyers. That Trostani discardant is quite good. So they get to gain 3 now. I'm just gonna block with the Mystic. Okay, well, they can do that. Well, that's exactly the reason I didn't want the Shadow Spear to... I mean, it will make the raising completely impossible here. So I have to do like a... like what? Yeah, the 6-6 lifelinker is just... which I can't even jump block with all my tokens. It's gonna be so miserable here. Fine. I'm just tired of this. I mean, there's no way I'm beating here. That opponent. They gain just life and I'm not gonna raise this thing anyway. The Verix won't do anything. I just have to take 6 a couple of times and then I die. And of course it was just not the 6-6. I could have grown my spell gauge to be a larger thing, but they had to research the redeem there. They could have started multiplying their tokens and they still had the Shadow Spear regardless. So that was completely, given all what they had, it was so impossible scenario because I knew my deck didn't have any outs there. How about this thing? This is going to be an excellent hand if I draw two lands in like my next 3 draw steps. If I draw just one, I have only the spell gauge we had in here. So this is actually very risky. I have to mulligan it. I mean, I do have early plays in my deck. Exactly so that I could have some reasonable starting hands, but I keep drawing all this expensive stuff here. Okay. So I'm gonna just lose one of the lands and... I mean, the Dowser can pick up the lightning, but... I mean, losing two lands here means that I'm gonna be able to play the Verix. Mulliganing to 5 does mean I would rather have this card advantage. Maybe I'll just lose the Wizard's Lighting and hope to draw something for the Dowser there, but yeah. Well, there is something to pick up with the Dowser. Well, that's the blue-white skies, I suppose. So this Mind Stone makes it sure that I can play the Verix next turn. I guess I'll do that. I can take the 2 damage here. Okay, that's in the cube as well. Didn't remember that. Okay. This can only block flyer as well, it's not that relevant. So let's play the Verix. I mean, I have 5 mana, at 7 I could kick it. I mean, I could play the Skewer here and then next turn the Dowser. If I draw multiple lands, there's a possibility that the Verix will do something good. Okay, let's see. Because if I draw like a ton of lands in here, I want to get the value from this kicker. If I don't, then I can play the Verix later. I don't think I'm gonna raise them that easily here now, because I'm only at 2 cards and they have 6, well, 5 now. So we have to maybe think for the longer game here. Because if my next draw will be a land, I'm definitely gonna wait for 7 mana. Kasmina isn't great for me though. Well, at least I used my targeted removal spell, but they're gonna get 2 1/1s and some additional quality improvement for the hand. They do seem to have a hard time deciding what to discard. So maybe they, well, that was just a land, but maybe they wanted to have, if that was their final land, for example. Well, this turn is anyway quite easy here. It has prowess, yeah. So next turn I can consider running the Verix if I don't draw a land. But if I do, I'm gonna just run the Prophet instead. But they will be, of course, be at 7 mana quite soon, and they will get even more advantage from this thing. It's gonna be a draw 4, discard 2. So given all they have also already had in this game, and I mulliganed to 5, they didn't mulligan at all. That's a lot of advantage for them. But I guess if I get 2 4/4 flyers that they maybe can't deal with, okay, and that draws them a card. And yeah, this skewer will... okay, they just wanna attack with this champion here. I mean, it's just a matter of time when they can play it, so I might as well take the block here to prevent some damage. Yeah, that's the land, so this is gonna cost 5 mana, thanks to this. If I wanna kill the guard mage, so I can't do both the Prophet and the Skewer here. And if I attack, they are gonna block. Double block with the 2/2s. So I can't try to get the spectacle happen here. I mean, I can't let this 2/3 survive for now. Maybe I'll just play the Prophet. Yeah, this gladly this kicker doesn't require any more red because I don't have more than these 2 sources for now. Okay, so opponent is still at 5 cards in hand. Yeah, they have gone 8 cards deeper than I, because I did the mulligan and they have drawn so many cards. Alright, so they're gonna have something like a... some pump spell there? No, they just made a misclick there. Okay then. Okay, that comes with a counter. So if they don't have a counter spell and I draw a land, I could be in a fine shape, but that's a couple of ifs in there. Especially if they pass now the turn, because it seems like they have something to play now. Okay, they did have, and they can take another card, mage drawing another card. Now, why would they do that? That makes no sense whatsoever. Okay, so I can attack with the Dowser. It has prowess, but... doesn't seem like it makes any sense, but I have to kill one of these guys, and I actually want to scry. So, well, I can scry with the Goblin Wizard too, but I think I need to. I mean, this is 6 damage in the air. It's quite a bit of damage, so... I suppose it doesn't matter really which one of them I kill, and it's gonna cost 5 mana, so... let's go. Yeah, I'll take the land. And it was the island this time. After it was so hard to draw islands in the previous games. The opponent is at six lands. So one more and they can eternalize this and net another two cards. That's gonna die and they get proliferate. Now I see them move with the... There was a reason for the... Reason for the shapeshifter after all. They wanted to make the 2-3 with the counter to have the proliferate thing going on. Well, I mean still... I'll get 2-4-4s. If they don't have an ability to answer them, I still can do the blocking business here. But if they have like a... Well, I mean, I guess they need two answers, because if they neutralize one of those, I still can block the one, and I can block the one of these 2/2s. That would leave me at one. Let's see them have like a Lala Mage's Domination here for the token. All for the cheap cost of 3 mana. Okay. So if they attack with all, they will lose the other error list and they will be dealing 5 to me. So let's see what they decide to do. Okay, I got no really options here. Why, they actually were able to proliferate this thing too. Oh, now I get these additional lands. These are not necessary now. That one is okay. Can't really attack with anyone. I mean, I guess I could... Should I expose myself? I mean, I could play the Goblin Wizard and kill the Kasmina before they get any additional value out of it. I mean, then they know not to attack with these guys. Otherwise, they might have attacked and I could have gotten some value out of things. Okay, I mean, I guess if I just attack... Okay, this is what I do. I can attack only one damage to it, because that means they can't use the draw effect there, so... Yeah. But of course, this means they have a lethal attack, so they should kinda understand that... I realized that, and this is just baiting, that I must have something, otherwise this attack was just stupid. And they can still have something like a counter spell in there, but I'm not gonna play around that kind of stuff. I have 27 damage here to deal. That's a lot. So I'm gonna take some risks and try to get some advantage. So if I hope they are gonna attack with all their guys now. But I suppose that's not gonna happen, because they don't have to. Next turn they're gonna have enough attackers, thanks to having so many. I didn't even see if I should try to find something else. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I shouldn't have kept this on top. But I mean, what does it matter? I wasn't gonna beat from that point. So there are flyers. Well, a few at least. Well, quite a few in fact. So what does that mean? I don't care about the Spectral Sailor, I won't care about the Cartus either. Phoenix. I mean, it does have an ability to brawl with flyers a little bit better. I guess I could lose the Burning Prophet and have the Phoenix in here. There's no way I'm gonna play the Angrath. They have unblockable flyers, so this Angrath might easily be attacked to death. So this is it, and let's hope to see one good starting hand here. Well, it's not the greatest because of these 5 drops don't do anything, but I have the Baral in here, and if I get the double vision early, Well, I mean, turn 5, unless I draw the Mind Stone, then I can have enough value generated by it that it's all worth it. Well, at least I have the 5 mana here now available, and I have even both double casters covered. Okay, so they are having an unsummon. Please play the unsummon right away. Well, that's not the worst draw to have. Yes, I got one extra damage there. Maybe should have put a post-combat main phase stop as well, because their turn ended immediately after they chose not to block, but... Alright. The Murmuring Mystic won't be that great here, unless I get to kill the eagle. Okay, what's this? I should have... Okay, whatever. I could have attacked for another 1 point of damage, but that's hardly mattering, because I can't beat this start. I don't think this deck is that bad, but... opponents have had, of course, very good decks too. But I have had a bit rough draws in here. I kept now a risky hand. But I kind of felt like there's a good chance for me to draw something. And I did draw actually the Murmuring Mystic here, which is a good one. But now I really... Before I get any value out of these things... Oh, come on, bastard cat. Before I get any value out of any of these three cards, I need to draw an instant on sorcery. I mean, basically all these four cards synergize with instant and sorceries, and I have a lot of them in the deck. But I drew none of them so far. But yeah, I'm not gonna beat the bastard here. Well, that's a good draw. Sure is. So if I draw something like a burn spell, I have to just... I don't even know if I should kill the eagle or the Basri. Probably Basri, yeah. But I suppose it's already too late now. They have such a good start. I mean, if I kill Basri... That does nothing. Yeah, only thing I can do is play the double vision and hope I draw something good. Shouldn't have done this pre-combat, but I guess it doesn't matter at all. Oh, come on, yeah, they have the unsummon. Just let me play. I will play the third match, of course, even though I can't win any additional prizes there. But I want to see if this deck actually can manage. Yeah. Well, I will see what kind of... if I draw some more, let's say, Electro Dominance. That could give me a small chance if I draw that specific spell. I could deal it to 4 twice. Okay, so they have that just in case to have the refill available at some point. So Electro Dominance, please.
I will guard your advance.
Apparate will be played, so I can actually get rid of the flyers there. But I can't get rid of the bastard cat. Unless I... And I won't be getting rid of it anyway in this turn. But Apparate is a good start, so I can play actually... Baral, and then I can play the Saheeli, and I still can play the Upgrade for 1 mana.
Prepare to marvel at my masterpieces.
And I basically can try to see if I can get lucky with it, with the Bastard activation. Yeah, I'm gonna play to counter spells, there's no really reason for me to. I mean, if they have a counter spell, then they deserve to win, whatever. I just hope they are trying to, for example, target the Empyrean Eagle. Anything but Champion of Witch in here, actually. No, that didn't work out. Well, in that case, that gets plus one, and indestructible. I, of course, have the blocker for this thing. Maybe they're thinking whether they want to attack Shahili or me. Well, let's see what it's gonna be. I don't know why they are attacking with the champion. I guess it means that they are gonna have some kind of boost spell, but I hope they do, because then I can respond to it. But well, let's see, because I'm gonna deal three to both of these, and because this Empyrean Eagle currently is boosting their aerialist, they will actually lose the aerialist as well if they don't have anything. But I suspect they do. But this was my best chance here. Okay, they didn't have anything for that, but I mean, they only need to. Okay, that's good then. So, okay, I can make the 1-1 now. Let's see. Target artifact becomes a copy of another target artifact or creature I control. It remains an artifact, so I can make like a play the Dowser in here. Then I can make this a 3-3 with prowess. And I can get the upgrade back, and I will actually have the mana to cast it as well. Well, who knows? I mean, that upgrade really... The upgrade in combination of them having no response to my, you know, double removal there was a huge, huge thing, in fact. They are thinking about their plays quite a bit here. Okay, 3 tokens. Well, that's a good one too. And actually, this is gonna cost 1 viewer, so I can play the Dowser for free here. Because I will put X equals to 5. And this would normally cost 7 mana, but the Baral makes it cost 6 mana in that case, so I can play the Dowser. The only thing that the Dowser wouldn't be able to return the Electro Dominance then, but maybe it doesn't matter. Anyway, I get to deal 5 damage here, so twice. So let's be smart. I'm gonna just kill the Bastricate and probably the Champion of Witch. Yeah, I guess. I mean, I don't have to play the Dowser here, of course. If I want to return the Electro Dominance, because this, of course, deals a bunch of damage to the opponent as well. But I guess I might want to have the 3-3 in the board here. Okay, kill this thing. And then I will... The copy will target, I guess, the Champion of Witch. I guess I can kill it. I mean, they are still somewhat far away from that amount of mana. And I think I'm gonna just not cast this thing. I wanna return the Electro Dominance instead. And then I will attack for 1 here. I have blockers for those 2/2s. Yeah, I mean, returning this makes more sense. I can deal like 10 to the opponent with, you know, X equals 5 and double vision target copies that one. It makes a lot more sense. My clock will be that much faster. Well, that can't kill anyone. It only prevents the damage though, but I have the flyers to deal with it. Yeah, so this actually does nothing. Okay, that's great. So yes, I need to deal with that wanderer first, but I can do that. You'll have to do better than that. I mean, I guess I could have. Well, maybe next turn I will make one of these artifacts flyer. I hope they don't have a flyer. I mean, of course they'll have a lot of flyers, so they could have a flying blocker. And I can't, yeah, the electro dominance won't deal any damage. Okay, that's... Well, they get to proliferate this thing. So... That's not so great, so even if I make now another... yeah, maybe I should have activated this on the previous turn already. But then again, my amount of my blockers would have been fewer, so... Okay, maybe it makes sense. Yeah, well, what's the hurry here? I mean, maybe I should have done it now, but... I don't know. If they had didn't have a flyer now, maybe they don't have a flyer now later either. Okay, one more mana for the champion of witch, but it's just a 4/4 ground guy. Of course they get to draw 4 cards there, so that's pretty bad, but okay, that's fine. I play the cutthroat now. But do they have like a... Because now if they have like some kind of, for example, they could have the unsummon. Which makes me kind of want to make a third flying attacker here. Well, that will be pretty nice. I'll get to double this thing. Yeah, I think I'll make. Just in case they have a... Let's see. Target artifact you control becomes a copy of another target artifact or... Okay, so I wanna do it like... Like this. To make sure I can get rid of the wanderer on this turn. I can make this go to 3 loyalty. But they can bounce this flyer in response. But at least then that's the unsummon used right there. Because it seems like they are holding something there. Okay, so now let's clock up the ground here. That's quite a few. Quite a few one-ones I will be having here now. Yeah, they can target one copy of there, but I will still get four here. I mean, actually I don't care if I have like 4 or 8 here in here. That wasn't gonna be very relevant to have this Splendor Mare as a good blocker to my ground guys, so only thing that matters is that I can... Well, actually, I get to Electro Dominance away, so... And this thing will be killed now, too, so... Okay, so next turn they can go for the champion here, but anyway, I get the double Electro Dominance in here. I get to kill the Splendor Mare and the Elite Guard Mage. Couldn't do the... Or maybe I don't have to kill the Splendor Mare. Because I can deal now, like a... X equals 6... because of the Baral still. I could deal 6 additional damage to their head, so-called. But I guess that Splendormare will be able to gain life at some point. It can be annoying. But it's only 3 life and I will multiple block it anyway, so fine. X equals 6. Kill the flyer. And then... do that. And then I will attack with my flyers in here. So opponent chose to do this, but is this a spirit? No. No, no, this is not gonna... oh man, that was so bad. This is... yeah, it doesn't target spirits. It only spirits can block them. Okay, well that was... they have a 3-3 lifelinker. I wish I used my Electro Dominance on the other copy on the Splendormare instead. So they can really just... okay, that departed. Well, I guess I have to draw. I'm gonna lose next turn. Yeah. Oh man. Yeah, I'm gonna lose to this. What a top deck. That was 5 unblockable damage for their next turn. All right. Well, isn't that a team in this draft? Well, opponent mulligans, I don't have the blue source. Now you see why I wanted to pick those, you know, lands, dual lands in the draft. It could prevent these kind of situations. And again, I mean... whatever. The electric dominance is probably the least useful in here. At least I got a good 2 drop here. They're gonna start gaining some life there, but it's an 0-5 thing, so maybe not such a big deal. Okay, so nothing to threaten the Sahili, and this will get another counter here. I could upgrade this thing, but I don't think. They already will have access to quite a few of mana, and they have 3 colors here regardless, so... yeah. Okay, tokens are gonna happen. Okay, let's see what's gonna be the payoff or Easter one. Well, that is decent, yeah. So do I need to leave the Sprite Dragon as a blocker in here? I suppose I do. Raising doesn't make sense when they have this 8 life coming up. At least this is a 3-3, but they can't attack with the 2-2s without... Well, they can, but they would lose. And okay, let's see what kind of pump effect they have. If I don't think they should attack unless they have some way to pump their team. Okay, so they are gonna attack. Let's see then. There's not much options for me here. Okay, like this. I mean, I can just hope they don't have a mass pump. If they have a mass pump, that's game over for me. They did not. So that was acceptable. Stab wound on that. Okay, that's annoying. But I get my 1/1 flyers with the Murmuring Mystic here. Well, of course they have also that thing, so now they just need to draw some countermakers. Okay, so I'm in a hurry in here. They have the 1/6 ram in here, but I suppose if I attack with all... I mean, I can lose a couple of tokens here. And, can use the upgrade then. Get rid of the discordant. Yeah, sadly they did do that to the artifact here. I could have used the Saheeli here to make it to 1/5 and get 2 flyers from the Murmuring Mystic, but it's not gonna happen now, sadly. Maybe I should have done that pre-combat, but maybe that would have been easier for them to realize what's gonna happen, perhaps. So now I do have a counter spell that makes them pay 4 more. I would of course rather just use this for a card draw. Okay, I don't think I'm gonna do that. So do I take the card draw? I don't think I'm gonna do it quite yet. Well, this is gonna be a fine one. Yeah, I think now I'm gonna just do this. Make like this happen, and I'm gonna just burn them to the face. Get a couple of flyers here and 1 ground guy, and I will keep the counter spell up here. Does seem like it makes more sense. So that will remove Exile an enchantment from your graveyard. There is one. So they will get like a 2/2 zombie, which will be in fact, thanks to these two, two. Okay, I will counter this if they don't have the mana available. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is exactly not enough because I can make them pay for 6. Absolutely. So I guess they have to only brick for one more turn, and that's it. They will gain one life, but that's not gonna be enough to... Yeah, they will have to draw something very good. Potentially something that makes a token. Because then they will get double the tokens and they will be 4-4 flyers. Okay. So green-white tokens. With a lot of the... And of course they are splashing for black. Aphemia, stab wound. Okay. Yeah, this is pretty sweet also with multiple tokens. If one effect makes multiple tokens, this can be pretty nice. So they don't have that many answers to flyers, so maybe I'm gonna play like the cartouche. And maybe the... Well, like at least maybe the Phoenix of the Ash. Of Ash. Okay, let's play that Phoenix. And maybe again the Burning Prophet won't be the greatest thing ever. And maybe the Brineborn Cutthroat won't be that great either. Do I want to have the Precision Bolt? There weren't that many creatures that dies to it. I guess the Aphemia is one target for that. I could just lose the Cutthroat and play like the... I mean, this can be also, you know, unblockable and make other things unblockable. Although my other things won't have that much power, so it's not that great, but 2-2 unblockable guy. That might be better than the thing I just removed the cutthroat. Okay. I suppose I try it like this. Yeah. That's why I want my dual lands. I hate this kind of starting hands. I have allowed a lot of these in this event. I mean, if this was a island, I could play this. I would have Abraid up one land away from these tree drops. But now that I don't have the island in here, I have the Abraid and Wizard's Lightning. That's what I'm thinking. This might be something I still can keep. Yeah, I'm gonna keep it. At least I have one more game if I lose this one. Because I have the Aberrate, and then if I draw a land in three draw steps, I can play the Saheeli or perhaps the Wizard's Lightning, whichever is more reasonable. Okay. Well, I mean, of course, I could also just not draw any land in three draw steps. Well, that's enough for Trust and Discordance. I have played quite a bit against those things. Do I want to put the neutralize in? I don't think I'm gonna have mana to keep up. So let's see if I can get a starting hand. Well, I can get a starting hand. That's not one I have to mulligan. Opponent has to mulligan. This match, of course, is no stakes match because it doesn't matter if I end up at 3 losses or 1 win and 2 losses. I won't be winning anything extra. But of course, I want to play optimally each game I have here. Okay, so either opponent is thinking about mulliganing to 5 or what card to throw away from their 6 card hand, and they kept the 6. Okay, I got the devils here. Well, now that... I don't know, maybe I'll just play the gutter snap so I can get the 2 additional damage from this. It's not really gonna be... I'm not gonna be able to attack with these devils, I don't think. If they play any other blocker. Well, I guess if it has 2 toughness or fewer, then I could have attacked with these devils, but this way I deal 2 additional damage. Frozen Tusker, okay. So Electro Dominance will be able to deal 4 damage on the next turn if I need it to. And then I can cast the Wizard's Lightning for free in that case. So let's see what kind of a play they have in there. I don't really feel like killing this thing, but on the other hand, it's gonna gain them a lot of life in this game. But if they have the Trostani Discordant in there, it's gonna be pretty miserable. Yeah, I'm not gonna kill the Ram quite yet. I could use the Mind Stone, but I'd rather use it on the end of their turn. Because if they have like a Trostani Discordant here, I need to kill it. But of course it will be amazing with the Path of Discovery because they will get 3 triggers from it either way. Opponent could be playing around counter magic too. Knight of Autumn. Well, that survives. Let's see if they try to kill the Mind Stone or make a... I suppose they're just making a 4-3 for themselves. Yeah, so they didn't get the counter from the Explorer, so I let this thing resolve. I'll draw the card first. And I think I'm gonna kill this thing. So what to return here? It's pretty annoying they have the 1 life each turn. The Guttersnipe would be a much better card here if they didn't have the constant life gain in there. But I guess I'm gonna take the Wizard's Lightning because this thing is a wizard, so I can't even use it. By the way, they did block one of these instead of the Gutter Snap this turn. I mean, I would have probably killed the thing with the Wizard's Lightning, but they played around 3 damage spell here. Okay, they drew a card and maybe they'll play a Death Thatcher now. That gets to explore as well. Bastion of Remembrance, they will keep it or lose it. It's not necessarily that high impact, but I mean they are tokens in their deck, so it makes sense. I'm not gonna play the Wizard's Lightning right now because I might wanna have the prowess trigger here. Okay, so what does this mean? But it first means that I'm going to simply play the Wizard's Lightning in here. And then I can attack with all these guys. And I'm now that that's happened, I guess I'm gonna just burn them to their face. Because I will prowess and this will be a 5-5 then. Actually, it will be a bit bigger. I'm gonna play this thing too. That was, by the way, a mistake. I should have used... Oh man. What if I had had X equals 3, I would have picked the Wizard's Lightning and have the 1 mana to cast the spell. Well, I mean, it doesn't matter actually. They were in a bad shape anyway, but I mean, this was simply a mistake by me. Because if I play the Electro Dominance with X equals 3 instead of 4, they would be at 5 now, but then when I get to, you know, I would have 1 mountain up, and this is a wizard. So I get to return with this experimental overload. These are Wizard's Lightning, and then I can play it with 1 mana, deal 3 plus a 2 from the Gutter Snipe, so that would have been the win anyway, but the opponent conceded there, so I did win the last match in this draft, but I think I like the deck, and I don't mind drafting this kind of deck again in this event, but sometimes you you can go less than 2 wins, it's not impossible. Anyway, thank you for watching. Let's see what I got here for the gems and some uncommons. And I will see you in the next draft. Bye bye.